Do you agree or you disagree? Julius Malema said, Mkhwanazi should be the police commissioner. National. I know. Let's just say, hey, Bon, where'd you get that? I've got an evidence. I've got a video that I'm about to give you of Julius Malema, who says that. So it's not a fabrication of evidence. No. This is definitely not a fabrication of evidence, but this is a true story. Wait, the question was, I need you got me distracted. The question was, do you agree or you disagree? Wait, Mkhwanazi, that man is angry. He looks at you and he says to you, are you a criminal? You say, yes. Atuzoyimela lento leyo. Uthena, ah, mina ngizoyimela. And I chose to be a criminal. That's okay. It's fine. We'll have a conversation. I'm told Mkhwanazi is highly trained as a special force, if I'm not mistaken. But, you know, don't take my word for it. I'm just saying that I'm told that man is highly trained. So it makes sense, though. I believe it in that look at his movement. The man is moving in an incredible way. And if you make Mkhwanazi a commissioner, hey, I'm a heist. So, I'm telling you. So, Jay, ngithi sanibona. You know, hello, Baba, lo. Akathi kusasa. Uthuthini? Hoy, mina, Mkhwanazi, mina, ngeke, mina, mfana, ngithi, ngeke. Okay, it's fine. So, xoxa, ngiyabuya. The next thing, that place will be surrounded with tapes and we'll be seeing people wearing white things, and you know those people are gone. That is what is currently happening. KZN. Oh, that man doesn't say tomorrow. Today. You resist us. We want to arrest you. You resist us. That is Mkhwanazi. Okay. Why you go? 55th, I need. Let's go. The next thing you hear, hi, there was gunshot there. And then this one died. That is Mkhwanazi for you. So I want to ask the question then. Don't you think it's going to get sued? And the reason I'm saying that is because we had a police force in the name of Amabaret. Yo, those guys were bangatik sas. Today, now you taxi drivers drive their nonsense and they will take you out. Say, hey, Baba, push ups. Hey, those guys used to discipline people. But yeah, there was a lot of lawsuits against them, and that would be my worry when it comes to Mkhwanazi. Right, but before I give you the video, got Julius Malema, I want you to do this. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying? Will bring you more, and also guys want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed.
Okay, I'm about to give you a video on Malema. So I was just saying, Guti, was talking to one of the person who's working for a South African police service, and that person said, we were talking about Amabaret, and that person says, do you know how many lawsuits they faced? They said that somebody was saying one of the reasons they had to stop Amabaret is because of lawsuits against them. Because those guys, Boba bosthola isibhaxa manje. Manje ayikusasa. Manje. Ukuthi uyami taxi driver, yeah, mina hey, manje. So, I'm saying if he becomes a national commissioner, he will need to tone down because he then becomes a target. And he is targeted by people who he's working with. Those are the very same people that are going to release the information to say, oh, you want him. This is how you get him. You know what I'm saying? But if they can't come to you direct, then they will have to use the sites. And then the state will complain and say, oh, we've got a lot of lawsuits now. No, you have to tone down. We can't pay these people because there are lawyers who will be looking to make money out of that. But wait, listen to what Malema has got to say here.
He must be the commissioner of police, that guy, or anyone similar to that guy. I told Begitele when we were in that place where the whites were trying to destroy a police station. Senegal, where it was me and Nkwenazi came, I said to Begi, this is the guy who must be a police commissioner, not these things you are offering to us all the time, who are driven by corruption and not to protect the streets and protect the integrity of the uniform. Go and look at Ntantla Mkhwanazi, even his posture. Eh? The uniform, not the cover. Ntantla Mkhwanazi, when you look at him, you see a man in uniform who's disciplined, who's determined to deal with crime in South Africa.
Okay. So, with that being said, having heard what Malema is saying, do I oppose the idea? Definitely not. Do I endorse the idea? Definitely yes. I'm just saying that when you reach that level, you need to be very careful. You need to be extra careful. Why? Because you're going to get targeted. There will be people that will target you because not everybody is happy with Mkhwanazi. Even among police officers, some of them are not happy. And it's a fact. You know, they are not happy because you bring him corners, it means them not getting the promotion, and others means them getting fired. So they are not going to sit down there and look and roll their hands and be okay with that. No, but the man, man, so far, I cannot help but acknowledge that, you know what? Ula magugu manje. So, I feel like criminals these days, bayaqanasa nje kwampunze edlemini nje uyabo bazenzela nje kwampunze edlemini ba nje. So it would be nice nabo to, you know, once the more you think of, you know, taking that money from that truck, you know, you will think twice and say, hey, if Mkhwanazi catches me, hey, I wonder what is going to happen of me. It's either I get that money and I run, no one catches me, or Mkhwanazi catches me. You know what I'm saying? So you have to decide. But now I feel like there's nothing that is challenging them. Like this thing, guys, you see people robbing look at this car, this cash and transit car, broad daylight. And the criminals these days, they don't even hide their face. Hey, Batum. No. I remember this guy, this hitman who went to kill somebody there, who was seeing shown his videos on CCTV. It was trending on Twitter. That man is not even hiding his face. That's how confident he is that I'm not going to get caught. So, you know, a strong hand will do. You know what I'm saying? A strong hand that will, you know, shake you a bit. And you know that, you know what? If I ever get caught, it's over. It's over. They are not coming to negotiate with me. They are just coming to finish me. You know, when you start having people reasoning that way, then there's a bit of fear. You know what? You can't just do as you please. Because the day they catch me, it's over. But yeah, there are people who are saying, hi, 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 hi. Because other people, really, they are benefiting from, there are women. Women, most of the time, there are some women. They know they are not involved in this criminal activity. Though the man risks his life to please them, and then the men get shot, and then they continue. So those girls, yeah, the girls of ours, you know what I'm saying? So they wouldn't be, to them, it wouldn't be a big deal because they are not losing their lives.